Hello children, once again you all are welcome to my channel Geography for Success. And as I have told you earlier also, that this is just an effort to make geography easy for you, okay? And I'm sure that when you go through these videos, you will find this topic especially very, very easy. I know it very well that the topographical sheets are quite difficult for many of the children. So this is just a small effort for you people. So if you find anyhow this video has helped you, so please subscribe, share with your friends. Okay, so let's start with it now. Today we have to start with a new topic in the same topographical sheets only, the conventional symbols. In the chapter Interpretation of the Topographical Maps, the conventional symbols form a very important, or you can say a very essential part of it, because the reason is, the symbols, if you don't know the symbols or the signs, whatever colors represent any particular thing, so how you will be able to interpret the topographical sheets? For that purpose, you have to understand each and every symbol, what for every symbol has been given in the topo sheet, what does it indicate? So let's start with it now. And as you have seen in the earlier topographical sheets which were there in the earlier years, right, those were a little different from what we have got now this year. So nothing to worry about it. Once you go through all these symbols and try to understand each and everything, and then once you have gone through all these symbols, try to interpret side by side the topographical sheets, and I am 100% sure that you are going to find it much, much easier than what it was earlier with you. Okay, so let's start. Now, conventional symbols is the topic today I have to start with you. First of all, children, many signs and symbols have been changed this year. What was there earlier as compared to that, you can find a lot of things have changed. So first of all, regarding the various methods of transportation, various means of transportation, for that the most important one is the roadways. Now, what are the various roads which are shown in the topographical sheet? For that purpose, you should go through all these symbols. Number one, you can see Express Highway, it is mentioned on the left side of it, and the symbols are shown on the right side. This is the first symbol, is for the Express Highway. Okay, then next one is the Express Highway with toll, with bridge, with distance stone. So first one is with the toll, second one is the Express Highway with a bridge, and third one is the Express Highway with a distance stone showing 20 kilometers distance. Right, next one is the roads, metal roads, especially according to their importance. All these are showing the, all these symbols are actually representing the metal roads only, but according to the importance, these have been categorized. The first one you can see, the magenta colored road, is actually the national highway. Okay, next one is the brown colored road, is for the state highway. And yellow colored road, which is shown in the topo sheets, that is always representing the district highway. Okay, now come to the next one. When the roads have been shown to you just now, in the next part of it, you can see there are a few white lines which actually is dividing the road into two parts. Okay, whether you are talking about the national highway or you are talking about the state highway or the district highway, district roads. So what is it actually? This means it has been divided into two parts with the help of a divider, right? And this is actually giving us two lanes, right? So that the traffic can be managed easily. One side of the road is providing the movement of traffic on one direction, and the other part of the road is providing the traffic to the other direction. Okay, now come to the next one. Next group is of the unmetalled roads, right? Unmetalled roads are also called many times as a kaccha road. Okay, so this first symbol is actually representing the unmetalled road. Next one is the cart track. This is the cart track. You can see a single line is actually shown for the cart track, right? Then next is the pack track. Pack track is actually the path which is formed by the foot movement of the animals, right? So that is called pack track. And next one is the footpath. Footpath is again with the dots, it has been shown, and this is actually, footpath means passage which has been formed by the movement of the people, right? Foot movement of the people. So same way, children, now you can see here that streams have been shown, right? Streams along with the canals, right? Then you can see one more very important thing you should notice here, that is the different types of dams have been shown by different symbols, especially the masonry dam. Masonry dam is actually the cemented, or you can say the rock filled dam is called as masonry dam. Okay, and it is always shown by red color mark. This type of symbol is red color, that means it is masonry. When it is black colored, it is earthwork. Okay, and the last one is blue colored, that is wear. Now come to next, the rivers. Rivers are again something very important thing which you should know, how these are shown and what are the important features we can find related with the rivers. Okay, these symbols are of the river. Okay, whenever a blue line has been shown within the in between the two banks of a river which is having small black dots, black dots indicate actually a dry river, or you can say seasonal river, not dry, but it is seasonal river, okay, which gets dry during the dry season, and which has again which starts flowing, or you can say a narrow water channel is there, then it can be shown with the help of a thin blue line. You can see in this symbol one thin blue line is there, so it actually indicates that the seasonal river, right? This is a seasonal stream with a perennial water channel which is flowing through it. Okay, when you will find this type of symbol, the second one, several islands are there. You can see small white colored small oval or round shaped symbols are there. This indicates actually the islands, right? When these islands are found in a river, these are called as riverine islands. Okay, and when this type of symbol is there, it shows a tidal river. So this is how, children, you have to understand all these symbols. Clear? Same way, the different railway tracks are there, and especially the broken ground is there, right? All these symbols you have to go through. So let's start with it now. I will show you a few pictures, and along with the pictures you will find it quite easy to understand all these symbols, children, right? Now first of all, let's start with it, all the three different types of roads. Okay, now all the three roads which we have studied just a little bit in the earlier part, all the three different types of roads according to their importance, right? These are, number one is shown by magenta color, number two is shown by brown color, number three is yellow colored, right? Magenta colored road, you can see not only the color but its thickness also can be easily you can say it is quite visible that it is a national highway. That means it is more wider than the state highways, which are shown by brown color. Okay, so this magenta colored roads are the national highways. Okay, and after that, the next one is the brown colored road, which is actually the state highway, right? And you can see even yellow colored roads are also there. These are the district roads. Okay, you can get a clear idea by this when you go through these symbols. Again, once again, I'm telling you, this is the first symbol is actually showing you the national highway. Okay, it represents national highway, right? And the next one, the brown colored road, which is shown in the topo sheets, is representing the state highway. And same way, yellow colored roads are district highways, district roads, you can say. Clear? Again, one more thing is related with this. When a white line is drawn in between the national highway, the symbol of national highway, you will be very clear by that it is representing a divider in between, right? And this means it is a double carriage national highway. Double carriage, that means wherever you will find traffic is too much, right? So to handle the traffic or to manage with the traffic, generally the double carriage roads are seen. But if you find the traffic is less in any area, that can be managed easily by single carriage. Okay, same way the state highway also works in the same manner. If the traffic is less, it can be managed by a single carriage national state highway. But when the traffic is too much, especially in the urban areas, you will find this is the problem. So there you will find the movements can be made easier when we divide the road into two parts. One side of the road actually handles the traffic going in one direction, and the other side of the road handles the traffic going in the other direction. So that is called state highway with a double carriage. Same way it works in the district road also. Whenever the district roads are having two parts, that is called as double carriage district road. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you all. Now let's go through very quickly through all these symbols which are given here. Number one is the roadways, right? The district roads are shown here. State highways are shown, national highways are shown. You can see national highway has been shown with the help of a small picture. It has been taken from the topo sheet only. You can see very clearly NH14 is written. That means it is a national highway number 14. Okay. Next symbol is of expressway. Expressway with a toll naka. Right. There is a toll naka, or you can say toll plaza is there. And here it is showing the expressway. Clear? Then come to the next side, the right side of it. Number one is the pack track. Pack track is just formed by the movement of animals. Okay. Next is the footpath. Footpath is formed by the movement of people, by the foot movement of the people. Then footpath with a bridge, pack track with a pass, and this is a cart track. Next one is the cart track. What is a cart track? Cart track is formed especially by the movement of various carts through that area. So that forms a passage. It is unmetalled only. And next one is the unmetalled road. Unmetalled road is shown in this manner. Okay. Now let's move to the next one. This is very clear to you now. Okay. Now you can see very clearly the picture in front of you. This is of a single carriage national highway. Children, just now I have mentioned in the earlier part, wherever you will find the traffic is less, right? In those areas, the traffic can easily be managed by a single carriage road without any divider in between. So this is an example of such a road, where you will find it is a national highway. It is a national highway, but it is having a single carriage. Okay, this is a single carriage road. Same way you can see in another example, one more picture is there. This is again a national highway. And so you can be very clear in the mountainous area, in the desert areas where the population is very sparse, there the roads are generally single carriage road. Okay, but as compared to that, you can compare this next picture with the earlier one. Here you can see a lot of traffic movement is there, right? Many vehicles are moving and in both the directions. Clear? So if it is not made double carriage, it's going to create problems. So to have a proper movement of the traffic, right, to manage a proper movement of the traffic, it is made in this manner. That means the road is divided in two parts, and one side of it is having, you can see the traffic is moving in one direction, the other side of it is handling the traffic movement on the other direction. So it is called double carriage road. You can see a road with a dividing strip between the traffic in opposite directions, right? So this is the example of double carriage road. Another example you can see here, right? When too much of traffic is there, you can see one road is going this way, the other road is the other side. The traffic is movement is there towards this side. So again, this is another example of double carriage road. Now come to the state highway. Now state highway, again a similar thing applies here also. When in the state highway you find the less transportation is there, less movement of traffic is there, it can be easily managed with the help of single carriage. This is the example of single carriage road. Okay, now let's have another example. This is of a double carriage road. You can see this is a state highway, right? But you can see one divider is there in between, which is separating two parts of the road, right? And in this you can see very clearly one part of it handles the traffic movement on one side and the other part of it is handling the movement on the other direction, right? This is a double carriage road. Now come to the next one. This is a district road. District roads are generally having less traffic, so it is shown in this manner, right? Now whenever any road has got a symbol like this, okay, you must have noticed also at several places, these are actually indicating the distance stone, right? It indicates a distance stone, and whatever number is there, that shows that much kilometers is the distance between the two places, right? Now come to the next one. Next symbol is that of the expressway. You can see very clearly the color which is shown here in the left top corner. The symbol shown here is the purple colored thick line is there, right? It shows always the expressways, right? And whenever there is again one white line is there in between, so it shows that it has been divided into two parts. That means it's a double carriage expressway, right? Along with this, one more thing you can notice here, it is another symbol on the expressway. This is, and well, it is written toll, T-O-L-L. And you can see what in actual on ground it is, this thing which is shown here by this symbol. Okay, this is actually toll plaza. This is called as toll plaza and it is shown by this symbol. Okay, now come to the next one. Another symbol related to the expressway. Wherever you find expressway with a bridge, that means any flyover is there or any bridge is there, you can see a clear example here in this case. So in that case you will find this symbol is applicable, right? Expressway is there with the double carriage movement, okay, and a bridge has been shown in this case. Okay, so this is another example. Now come to the next. Just now in the earlier part I told you children, wherever you find this type of stone, right, it is actually called as distance stone, and these are mostly found along the roads. And when suppose we are moving by road, we are traveling anywhere and we have to reach Mumbai, right, and we have reached to this point where this stone is there on one side of the road, so it shows how much distance is Mumbai from this particular point, what is the distance of Mumbai from this point where this stone is placed, right? So in this way, it is actually the it helps in finding out how much distance is left between the two places when we travel from one place to the other. Okay, now come to the next thing. Next is, you can see again the state highway, right? And wherever you will find again the state. Achha, one more thing is there, children. I want to tell you this again. Whenever the distance stone has got yellow color mark, you can see here the upper part is colored by yellow color, right? Always it shows a national highway. That means the distance stone is placed on the side of a national highway. Okay, but when we find the distance stone has got green color, you can see very clearly in this part, green color is shown. That means it is placed along a road which is a state highway. Right? Is this clear to you? So this is the difference between a state road, state highway, and the national highway, and the distance stone showing the two conditions. Okay, next is a road with embankment. At several times you will find the roads are there, the symbol, and on the sides of the roads you will find this type of symbol is there, right? Now you will think that what is the need of embankment along the road. You must have noticed at several places this type of thing, you can see in the picture. This is actually called as embankment, right? On the side of the roads, higher land is made. And what is the purpose of it, you know? What can be the purpose of it? Just think of it. One main purpose is to block the, you can say, to keep water. Suppose the water is the other side of the road, right? If the water is logged, right, due to heavy rainfall, water logging is there, it doesn't allow water to move towards the roadside. Moreover, to some extent, it creates problem for the animals also to move freely on the roads, especially where we find any forested area. There are always chances of several wild animals to enter on the roads. So this actually keeps the animals and or the water and all on one side of it, right? That's why the embankments are made, right? And you can see the symbol of it. Then another example you can find, many times you will find over the mountainous area when we travel, right? On one side of it you will find there is a mountain, the other side it is a deep valley, right? So along the other side also, when we have valley, there also you will find a wall is made, right, for protection point of view, to keep the vehicles safe. The walls are made, and this also can be shown with the help of the same symbol, which is called the road with embankment. Okay, now let's move to the next one. Next one is the unmetalled road. Now what is unmetalled road? I told you in the beginning also, it is also many times called by the name Kacha Road, right? What is Kacha Road now? Beta, when it is not cemented, or it is not, you can say, prepared with the help of the charcoal. So this is generally, soil is there still on the road. This is called Kacha Road, right? And the symbol of Kacha Road, you can see very clearly given here at the top. This is the symbol of Kacha Road. Okay, now let's move to the next one. This is actually just a picture to show that how the cart tracks are made. Okay, this is the symbol of a cart track. You can see on the right side the symbol is there, right? I'm showing you here with the help of cursor. So this is the symbol of cart track, but how the cart tracks are formed, you can see very clearly. It's again an unmetalled road, you can say, or a car track is actually for, it is not exactly a road. It is formed by the movement of the carts, right? It can be bullock cart. Generally, it is commonly seen near the rural areas, right? So this is a car track. Then come to the next one. Generally, an unmetalled road, right? An unmetalled road when it is lying in this manner, it is the soil is there over the surface. So it can always have mud during the rainy season, right? That's why there is one symbol, children, in the topo sheets. Many times you will find it is mentioned along a road, motorable in dry season. What does that indicate? Motorable in dry season, along a car track or along a an unmetalled road, you'll find it is written motorable in dry season. That means what? During the rainy season, it will get muddy, so the movement of vehicles will be very difficult, right? So for that purpose, it can be moved. Actually, the vehicles can move easily during just the dry season, not in the rainy season. You can see on the right side, I have shown you a picture, a small picture of a topo sheet. I have shown you here. You can, if you can observe here, I am showing you with the help of cursor in this part, right side, motorable in dry season. It is written over here, right? Over the car track, along the car track, it is written here. That means it is only used, it can be used by the vehicles during the dry season. Otherwise, if in the rainy season we want to use it, it will be having this condition. You can see in front of you, right? Or another picture I can show you. If the vehicles will use this for the movement during the rainy season, this will happen. Okay, so I think this much is very, very clear to you all, children, right? Now let's move to the next one. This is actually a graveled unmetalled road, okay? And it is simply the stones are spread over this part, right? Or the gravels are spread over to keep it safe actually from the muddy condition, right? In that way, it is saved from the muddy condition, which generally happens during the rainy season, because it is not totally metal road, right? So in such conditions, this road cannot get muddy so easily, right? For that purpose it is done. Now come to the next one. Next symbol is there, children, the small dots, right? Red colored dots are there, and it always indicates the footpath. But one thing, let me make you very clear here. Footpath is not the footpath we use generally in the cities and all, right? Here in the urban areas, we find the footpath is there on both sides of the road, right? Which is meant for the movement of people by foot, right? But this is not the footpath which we are mentioning here in the topo sheets. We are actually talking of the footpath which you can see in the next picture, this one, right? This is a footpath which is formed in a jungle area, or you can see in a forested area, okay? And what is this? This is formed by the foot movement of the people from one place to the other. When they move through the jungle area or through the forested area, this type of a cleared passage is formed by that movement, and this is called footpath. It cannot be used by any of the vehicles. It is just for the movement of people by foot, right? And you can see on the other side, the top left corner, the symbol has been shown, which shows the footpath symbol, okay? Now come to the next one. This is another symbol. It is also representing the footpath only, but when this type of symbol is there, if you can relate this with a type of bracket which you use in maths, right? This is a type of bracket, and whenever this type of symbol is there, right, this is actually showing a bridge, right? Okay, a bridge with footpath. Clear? So this is actually a footpath which is formed along with a bridge, a small bridge you can say, right? Now come to the next one. Next is, you can see very clearly, children, in the picture which is there in front of you, very narrow passage has been formed, right? If you see this is actually showing you the footpath, right? This is actually called footpath. When there is a vegetation area, right, or in forested area, when the people start following the same path, okay, for the movement, so that path is comparatively clear, right, for easy movement, then that develops into a footpath, that can be called as a footpath, right? Now in rest of the part you can see footpath is there, but rest of the area is covered by a little vegetation, and this vegetation type is called as the open scrub, right? The vegetation which you can see here, it's not a very dense vegetation. In what condition you find this type of vegetation? Especially in those areas where the rainfall is very scanty, right? Very scanty rainfall areas are there where you will find the open scrub type of vegetation can be seen, right? Another picture is there, children, which I want to show you here. This is actually a picture of a pack track, right? Pack track with a pass. You can see two small hills are there, right? In between the two hills, the cattle or the animals, when they start moving, every time when they move through the same path, it forms, actually it develops into a pack track, okay? And you can say it is a pack track with a pass, okay? This is the symbol you can see on the right side of it, right? This is a pack track with a pass. You can see another picture of the pack track. When the regular movement go on, it results into a cleared passage, and that is called a pack track, okay? Another picture of open scrub, children, I want to show you so that it will be more clear to you. You know, this is another, actually it's a type of vegetation only, you know. Open scrub is a type of vegetation. But one thing you should understand related with this. Open scrub always indicates that the area receives very less, or you can say scanty rainfall in that region. Right? You can easily relate that with the person who is standing here. You can see, children, the person who is standing, he has got an attire which you can relate with the people who are there from Rajasthan or Haryana or Gujarat side, right? Drier areas, arid regions. So there you will find a lot of such conditions. Open scrub can be seen a lot in those areas, right? So in which type of climatic conditions it can be seen? Hot and dry climatic conditions with scanty rainfall. Okay, what occupation you can find in such areas, especially because this area is not so good for cultivation, neither it is having any forested land. So this is the vegetation we can find. So what occupation is related with this? It is basically the animal rearing or animal domestication. Okay, right, sheep rearing, goat rearing, you can say. This is the main occupation of the people in those areas, right? Now children, here we are talking about the total roadways. Now here I am taking a break, and after this I will continue with the other means of transport, that is called railways. Okay children, and once again, if you like the video, don't forget, share it with your friends and also subscribe it. Thank you.